Welcome to Bishop Tyrrell Anglican College's production of The Internet is Distract. Oh look, a kitten!
Boxing cat, 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 boxing cat.
I don't know. Aren't you a little tired of cat videos?
No. What kind of horrible question is that?
What?
How would I ever get tired of seeing a cat do incredible or stupid things? I mean, can you imagine what it must have been like 30 years ago? A cat would box, put on gloves, and box like a human. And then their owner would just like, that's cool. I'm just going to keep this amazing boxing cat to myself. And then we would just like, never get to see it.
I guess that's true.
Micah!
Yeah! Hold on, my mom's calling me. Minimize windows.
What are you doing? I thought you said you're finishing your Gatsby paper.
I am.
Well, it doesn't look like you're doing it.
Mom, look. I have one paragraph left to write. That's like three sentences, and then I'm done. It's not going to take me that long.
Well, you have to leave for school in 20 minutes. Are you sure that's enough time? You promised me you'd be done.
Mom, I swear, I know exactly what I'm going to write. It's going to take me 5 minutes at most.
Fine, but I want to see it before you leave for school, so turn off your internet browser and get to work.
What if I need to look up something?
Then you can turn it on for as long as it takes you to look up that specific article. But otherwise, I want you to turn it off. Understood?
Okay, yeah, fine. I will. Maximize window. Hey, I gotta go. My mom's being really annoying about this Great Gatsby paper.
Alright, I'll see you later. Oh, hey, I'm thinking of making a meme out of boxing cat. So if you have any good meme headings, send them my way. I was thinking of this cat lacks to punch.
I don't think that makes sense.
Micah, it's the internet. It doesn't have to make sense, as long as it's loud and repetitive.
Yeah, okay. I'll let you know if I think of anything. Close windows, turn off Wi-Fi. All right, three more sentences. Here we go. In the end, Jay Gatsby never did get what he wanted. His precious and elusive light. Shoot, what color was the light? Blue? The book's cover is blue. His precious and elusive blue light. The light's not blue. Darn, it's Wi-Fi on.
Hi, welcome to Google, where we have everything you want forever. Would you like a search engine, email, calendar, cloud computing, a terrible social media platform no one uses?
Wikipedia.
Wikipedia, wonderful, coming right up.
Hi, welcome to Wikipedia.
Hey, you're back. What, did you finish your essay?
No, I told you. I couldn't remember what color the light was in The Great Gatsby.
What light?
The light? The light that haunts Jay Gatsby? Daisy's light?
I don't remember there being a light, but I did skip through a lot of it. It was really long.
It's 180 pages!
Yeah, But anything over 140 characters, unless there's emojis, is kind of hard for me to follow these days.
Well, look, there's definitely a light in The Great Gatsby. And I know Mr. Fishbein will knock off points if I get its color wrong, so...
Oh, hey, have you seen The Great Gatsby? Open YouTube.
New York, 1922. Temp of the city had changed sharply. The buildings were higher, pies were bigger, the morals looser, and liquor were cheaper.
No! No more cat videos! I have to work. Close window.
That cat just cited The Great Gatsby in perfect English. How are you not impressed by that?
Taylor, I really have to finish this.
Fine, just chat me again when you're done.
Close window, maximize Wikipedia.
Hi, welcome to Wikipedia, a collaboratively edited, multilingual, free access, free content, internet encyclopedia. Wikipedia is a mostly reliable resource.
Yeah, what color is the light in The Great Gatsby?
Not found. Contents of The Great Gatsby, 1.1, historical context. 2, plot summary. 2.1, major characters. 3, themes.
Never mind, this will take too long. Search for light.
Gatsby spends many nights staring at the green light at the end of her dock across the bay from his mansion. The colour of the light is green due to Daisy's romantic attraction to Kermit the Frog of Muppets and Sesame Street fame. In chapter 5, she insists...
Green! Okay, the light is green. Thanks, that's all I need. Wait, Kermit the Frog? What was that? Kermit the Frog wasn't in The Great Gatsby?
Uh-oh, looks like you found a whoopsipedia. We at Wikipedia believe anyone should be allowed to edit and contribute to the articles on our website. However, this can occasionally lead to errors, as we encourage people like this to participate.
Well, I think Kermit the Frog should be in everything, because I love the way his green felt feels on my skin. But that's not weird. You're weird!
Oh my god. You were the main source for my essay?
Yes, I know. Studies have shown that over 90% of high school students use Wikipedia as a source for their essay, which is quite frankly terrifying.
Well, I'd better go to a different source to make sure the light is green. Close Wikipedia, new window.
Hi, welcome back to Google, still your best and easiest option for searching the web, playing a movie, and getting your picture taken without permission. How can I Google your day?
Just a search engine, thanks.
Wonderful. Search for anything and everything you could ever possibly want, with no strings attached. Except that I'm storing every search you do and selling it to the marketing companies and the NSA.
I'm sorry, what?
Nothing. What can I help you search for? Bet you, I know what you want before you do. The Green Mile? The Grinch? The Graves of Wrath?
No, just wait. The Great...
The Greatest Showman? The Great Depression? The Great Santini?
The Great Gat...
The Great Gabby! The Great Galveston, Texas!
The Great Gatsby!
The Great Gatsby. First try.
No, wait, not just The Great Gatsby. The Great Gatsby light color question mark.
The Great Gatsby light color? Results from Smoob.com. The green light isn't the only symbolic color in The Great Gatsby. Fitzgerald uses colors like a preschooler.
Green! The light is green. Thank you. Close win.
Hey, any interest in buying The Great Gatsby book and movie for the low price of $3.99? Just click here and you'll have it.
Hey, heard you into lights. At lights.com we have a wide variety of lights, including green. Click me!
Oh, for the... I just typed that. How did these ads find me so quickly?
I don't know. It's probably a coincidence. There are no coincidences, there's only Google, except that we know everything about you and your life will be infinitely better.
What?
Nothing. Hey, do you want to see a cat video?
Pizza, pizza, cat. Pizza, pizza, cat. Pizza, pizza, cat.
No! My mom was right. I'm never gonna get this done unless I turn off the internet. Wi-Fi off.
Micah!
Hey, what?
What do you mean, what? Have you finished your report yet? You have to leave in 12 minutes.
I know, I'm sorry. I couldn't remember what color the light was in The Great Gatsby, so I went online to Wikipedia, but then I wasn't sure if Wikipedia was accurate, so I went on to Google, and then these ads.
Just wrap it up. You've been late 6 times this month, and I'm sick of it. Shut off your computer and get it done.
All right, where was I? In the end, Jay Gatsby never did get what he wanted. His precious and elusive green light. He believed there could be a life better than he had at the time, so he was always reaching, always looking, and... Hello?
Hey, where'd you go?
I told you, I have this paper to finish.
We'll get back online. Now. Jenny and Mark just broke up.
Oh God, not again. The last time they broke up, they were so dramatic about it.
I know, so get back online and like write their statuses before they think you've taken a side.
I have like one sentence left to write. Do I really have to do this now?
Yes, you know how Jenny and Mark are. They're sad, soulless people who only find self-worth and status likes. Do it now, unless you want to get on their bad side.
Fine. Wi-Fi on, go to Facebook.
Hey, hey, you're on Facebook. Who do you want to look at? Because you can look at anyone, ex-boyfriends, crushes, celebrities. Look at all their pictures. Look at what they're saying. Look at them all the time. You want to see babies? Everyone posts pictures of babies on here.
Oh my God. You know, this is the reason I don't go on Facebook anymore.
Yeah, but you haven't ended your account yet, have you? No, you haven't. Because sometimes you like to look. Looky, looky.
Just give me Jenny Schumer's page, please.
Yeah, Jenny, no problem. She posts all kinds of pictures.
Just give me her page, you creep.
Facebook status. Thank you to all my true friends who liked my new status. It gives me strength and a well of fortitude during this incredibly traumatic time for me. Just remember, you are beautiful in every single way. No words will bring you down. Christina Aguilera. Not only is she a singing contest judge, but she's also a poet for my soul.
Gross. Jenny. Like.
So, who do you want to look at? Because you can look at anyone. You don't even have to tell nobody you're looking at him. You can just be like, I like your picture, and lick your lips like this.
No, you are so disgusting. Just give me Mark Nutter. Thank you.
Status update. Dark days, guys. Dark days. The Cure once said that boys don't cry. Well, they do today. They so do today. I appreciate the support I've gotten from everyone so much. You'll never truly know what your words have meant to me.
God, you guys are the worst. Like and...
Message from Jenny. Hey, Micah. I just wanted to let you know how much I appreciate that like. You have no idea what it's been like these past few hours.
Come on. To Jenny, no problem. I'm sure you'll get through it, but I know it must be tough.
Message from Mark.
No!
Hey, Em, you have no idea how much I appreciated that like. Literally, thank you so much.
To Mark, well, I hope that's not literally true, as I think you'd be dead. But I get what you mean. Hang in there, you're a great guy.
OMG, you have no idea. It's literally been the worst thing that's ever happened to me.
Do either of you know what literally means? To Jenny, wow, it must be really bad then. Hang in there, you'll get through it.
That's some really solid advice. Literally, thank you so much. Hey, Em, if you're not doing anything tomorrow, a bunch of us are hanging out at my pool. Nothing too crazy, just a solid support group to help me through this incredibly difficult time.
Hey, Micah, a bunch of us are going to the ice rink tomorrow, kind of as a pick-me-up for this horrible place I'm literally in right now.
No, stop!
Just a few really good friends.
Just like 5 or 6 people. Don't worry if you can't skate, neither can I.
It would literally mean so much if you would come.
To Mark and Jenny, sorry I'm literally grounded, but hopefully we'll hang soon. Close window! And close out of face-
Wait. You can't leave yet. Look at all these links to articles you can read. Look at all these pictures and videos and birthdays people are having.
I can't. I'm gonna be late for school.
Taylor just sent you an invite. And you know how Taylor gets when you don't respond to her invites.
Fine, show me the invite.
Hey, Taylor just invited you to play Knock Grandma Off Her Chair, pig version.
What? What is that?
Sounds like a game. Sounds like a really fun game. A lot of people are playing right now.
No, I can't. Wi-Fi off. Wi-Fi on, G-Chat Taylor.
Hey, what's up?
What is this? Why'd you invite me to play Knock Grandma Off Her Chair?
Because I'm an amazing friend who wants you to play the best game ever. Here, I'll send you a link.
Oh, come on. This can't really be a game.
Just try it for like 2 minutes. I mean, it's really stupid, but it's also weirdly beautiful.
That can't be true.
Hey. Don't knock it till you've tried it.
Fine, click on link.
Knock Grandma Off Her Chair. Get your pigs ready.
Ha! Nice try. Go ahead, just lunch. Why don't you go play for the Brooklyn Dodgers, you noodle arm?
Wow, this grandmother's a real jerk.
Here, take this! On my cataract!
Ooh, Grandma got some pig on her face.
This is ridiculous.
Just wait till level 2 and when they give you the pig bomb.
What?
Trust me, it's hilarious. Use it at least once.
Level 2, ready for more Grandma?
Go ahead, just whippersnapper. I survived Great Depression because sure as heck survived you.
We'll see about that.
I should try it.
Pig bomb now available. Would you care to use it?
Heck yeah, pig bombs away! My arthritis!
Grandma got blown up. Pig
Take
star.
That, Grandma.
Micah.
Mom, what? Wi-Fi off.
That's it. Go to school right now.
But I haven't finished my report.
And by the looks of it, you're never going to, unless your report somehow involves hitting a defenseless grandmother with a pig.
It's just a game.
It's offensive. Think how Nana Burke would feel if you hit her with a pig.
Come on, Mom. This is obviously not the same.
It would kill her. A pig at that velocity would kill Nana.
Mom, look. I'm sorry I got distracted. I went online because Taylor called me because there was this whole breakup drama, which honestly would have affected my science report had I not.
I don't want to hear any more excuses. Turn off your computer and go to school.
Mom, look. I have 5 more minutes before I have to leave. I have one sentence left to write. Do you really want me to not turn in this report? A report that's worth 20% of my grade? Because you want to prove a point?
5 minutes. Then I want you out of this house and on your way. No more excuses.
Great, thank you. I promise this will take like a minute. All right. Where was I? In the end, Jay Gatsby never did get what he wanted. His precious and elusive green light. He believed there could be a life better than he had at the time, so he was always reaching, always looking, and each time he would reach, he would be pulled further and further from reality until his own life was taken away from him. Done. Mom, I'm done. Done. Wi-Fi on, G-Chat Taylor.
Hey, what's up?
I don't have a lot of time. The Great Gatsby essay. How many quotes were we supposed to use?
4, why?
Darn it, I have 3!
Just tack one onto the end. Mr. Fishbein loves when you end an essay with a quote.
Okay, but which one? I don't have time to look through the whole novel and...
Ask Fiona. She practically has the Great Gatsby memorized. She'll give you something good that fits with your theme.
Yeah, okay, good idea. Thanks. Close window, G-chat Fiona. Hey, Fiona.
Hey, Micah, what's up?
Look, I'm in a bind and I hear you're a huge Great Gatsby fan.
Oh yeah, I've literally memorized The Great Gatsby. And unlike Jenny and Mark, I know what literally means. Hey, wanna hear me recite the whole book? In my younger and more vulnerable years, my father gave me some advice.
No! Fiona, I'm really impressed you have the whole book memorized. I just don't have the time. All I need is a quote that will end my essay about the unrealistic desire of the American dream.
Oh yeah, I could give you a quote.
Wow, that's great. You'd really be helping me out. You have no idea.
No problem. I'm happy to help out any of my friends. I'm very loyal to all of my friends.
Great. So am I.
Are you really, Micah?
Yes.
Well, my loyal and best friend Jenny said that you were taking Mark's side in their devastating breakup.
I'm not taking anyone's side. I'm just trying to be friends with both Jenny and Mark, okay? Is that allowed?
Well, she feels like you're taking his side.
Fine, just what can I do to prove to Jenny that I'm still her friend?
Beats headphones, the earbud ones.
What? She needs headphones?
She doesn't need them. It'd just be nice to have a spare pair that just lives in her gym bag.
Fine, I'll buy her Beats earbud headphones. Just give me a minute. Amazon!
Hey, welcome to Amazon. What can I get you?
I heard you were into Beats headphones.
Well, I heard you went to The Great Gatsby. We have The Great Gatsby in books, CDs, DVDs, and Blu-ray.
It's fine, I just need...
Wait, we also have The Great Gatsby in appliances, automotives, jewelry, and clothing in men's, women's, girls, boys, and babies. And look at this Daisy Buchan onesie.
I don't need Great Gatsby anything, okay? Who even told you I was reading that book?
It definitely wasn't me. I'm just a multi-purpose search engine. Why would I tell anyone anything about what you do online?
Hey, I heard you were interested in Beats headphones.
Oh, that is so creepy. Google, get back here!
Hey, I know it's invasive, but it's so easy, isn't it? I mean, look at all the Beats headphones we have on sale this week. In fact, every week. Every year. And if you think something's overpriced, we'll crush your manufacturer into bankruptcy, okay? We will do that for you. We will. Just please don't leave until you bought more stuff.
Fine. Whatever. I'll take a pair of headphones.
Oh, fantastic. Are you sure there isn't anything else you want? We have a video streaming service, a cloud service, and a phone that no one likes. And,
look, it's fine. I just need to...
Wait. Here at Amazon, we're developing stuff all the time. For example, TV shows, delivery drones, and this. A cutting-edge, state-of-the-art tie that ties itself. It can tie itself up. Look. Darn it, it'll work eventually, I think. In the meantime, just take a Kindle Select of books. It's mostly creepy fan fiction, but it's free with Amazon Prime.
No, I have to go. Close window. G-chat Fiona. Okay, headphones ordered. They should arrive from Amazon in 2 days.
Great. I'm sure Jenny will appreciate how supportive of a friend you're being.
Yeah. I'm just really pressed for time, so if you have that quote...
Okay, so you said your theme is the elusiveness of the American dream.
Yeah, more or less.
No amount of fire or freshness can challenge what a man will store up in his ghostly heart. Nick Carraway.
Wow, that's good.
I know, I really love The Great Gatsby. And any time you want me to recite a chapter by heart for you, I will.
I don't think I ever will, but that's good to know. Thanks, Fiona. Close window. Cut and paste the quote and print. Okay, Mom, I'm done for real this time, and I still have a minute and 45 seconds before I need to leave for school. Mom, are you still home? Whatever. Wi-Fi off, computer shut down. Wi-Fi off. Wi-Fi off.
Hey there, is there anything I can help you with?
No, I'm just trying to shut down my laptop. But I guess it doesn't really matter. It'll just go to sleep in a few minutes anyway.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Getting offline seems like such a stupid thing to do anyway, right? Hey, are you sure you don't want to take a minute to quickly look at some of your favorite sites? There are 20 new articles you haven't read. News updates, sports scores, gossip?
No, I really have to go. I only have...
What about a movie? Or a TV show? I know you've been binge-watching that show about those sexy 20-somethings in a dystopian prison on the moon. The next episode's really good. Huge twist.
Oh, come on, I love Moon Jail! Just tell me, are Cora and Michael finally getting back together? They've been milking it all season.
I don't know.
No, I can't.
What about these clickbait articles? I mean, who doesn't like a slideshow about celebrities?
Hey, wanna see what these super sexy celebs look like without makeup? Spoiler alert, they look horrible!
Wanna find out which celebrities have extra toes? Click here to find out which ones.
Click here to see the 9 celebrities who weirdly resemble mass murdering dictators.
No! I always wanna click on these, and every time I do, I feel like a creep. I was right. I'm just gonna shut off my computer and go to school. I've been online way too much this morning, so I guess I'll just do it manually. What? What's happening? Why can't I move my arm?
I don't know. Maybe because after so many hours mindlessly looking at your computer screen, I figured out a way to burrow into the synapses of your brain and control your central nervous system.
What?
Nothing. Look, let's just think about this reasonably. Do you really want to leave all this and go to school? Really? 45-minute periods just looking at just listening to one person speak about one subject? You're not a caveman, Micah. Why do that when you can be online and watching a movie and shopping and watching a cat do something crazy all at the same time?
Hey, do you know there are over 100,000 cat videos on YouTube and growing? You've only watched 57. You really need to catch up.
Wasn't it frustrating that you couldn't beat me on level 2 after level 1 was so easy? Give it a couple more tries. I'm sure you'll move on.
And I'm not saying don't learn. Just learn at home, in the comfort of your own home, in a chair, in a comfortable, depleting your bone density chair. Aren't you tired of standing? Don't your bones hurt?
No! I like standing. I like going on walks and talking to people. I like being a person.
But why? Online you have limitless possibilities. There's no rules or curfews or gravities. It's everything and anything, and all you have to do is give up a few tiny personal freedoms that you don't seem to care about anyway. So why don't you just sit on your butt and watch cat videos and everything will be fine.
Sit on your butt.
Watch your cat sit on your butt. Watch your cat sit on your butt. Watch your cat sit on your butt. Watch your cat.
No.
Sit on your
I
butt.
I want to run.
Watch your cat.
I want to see the sun.
Sit on your butt. Watch your cat.
There,
sit
there.
On your butt.
It will be
watch
all right. It'll be all over soon.
Sit on your butt.
No, it
watch
won't. No, I'm not going to be a slave to you. I'm going to stop going online and I'm going to spend more time outside.
Pun?
Until you get bored.
And then what are you going to do? Stay bored? No, you're going to check your Facebook page, or email, or TikTok, or whatever stupid thing is trending right now. Your ADHD won't let you just stay outside, you idiot! Websites? Go get Micah's brain.
No!
Ah, I'm flushed here! Taylor, what are you doing here?
You weren't answering your phone, so I figured the internet was fighting for control of your brain.
What? How could you know that?
They tried to do the same thing to me last week.
They did? Then why are you still going online?
What do you expect me to do? Just not go on the internet? I'm not Amish, Micah. It's all about setting limits. 4 to 6 hours max. Anything any more than that and Google starts to change the way your brain works.
Okay, so how do we get out of this?
Here, use these pigs as boxing gloves and let's fight them off.
We're supposed to fight them off with cartoon pigs? What sense does that make?
It's the internet, Micah. It doesn't have to make sense, as long as it's loud and repetitive. Now use these pigs as boxing gloves and let's kick some app!
Hey!
Ah!
Bam!
Take that!
Crash!
Look out!
Pig! Mom! Hey,
Taylor? What are you doing here?
I thought Micah needed my help with her essay, so I came by and...
Well, time's up. Whether you finished or not, it's time for school.
No, I'm finished. And Mom, you were right. I really need to start putting some limits on online stuff.
I'm glad you're being open-minded. We'll talk about it later tonight.
See you later, Mrs. Carson.
Bye, Mom. I have soccer after school, but I shouldn't be home too late.
Okay, bye, sweetie. Good luck in your algebra test. Love you.
Love. You were right. Micah has more willpower than I gave her credit for.
No matter. She'll come around. They all do eventually. Do you want to look at some sweaters on Pinterest?
Oh, God, yes.